Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. In this video, I'm going to show you about my project, e-commerce project, or we can say online shopping project, which I have developed by using the technologies. For backend, I have used Java, Spring Boot for REST APIs. For frontend, I have used React.js, and for backend project management, I have used Maven and the server which will use for executing our backend application. For that, I will use Spring Boot's embedded Tomcat server only. And for the database, I have used MySQL. And for the database connectivity and the database operations, I have used Spring JPM. User modules present in the project. The very first one is administrator module. The second one is customer module. The third one is delivery person module. And now let's see the functional module of the project also. So the very basic functionality will be user authentication method, like admin, customer, or delivery person should be able to perform their authorized functionalities only after the login. Then the second module is product module, where we can add product, update product, delete product, search product, and view the products on the screen. Then the third one is category module, where we will add the product category. We can update the category, we can view all the categories, and we can search the products by categories also. The fourth one is the cart module, wherein customer will be able to add the products into the cart. He can remove the products from the cart, view his cart, and he can see the total amount of the cart. The next module is order module, wherein customer can order the products, view his orders. The next module is delivery module, wherein admin can assign the delivery person for the orders. A delivery person can view his delivery orders, and he can update the delivery status for the orders. The last module is payment module, wherein customer have to pay the amount for successfully ordering the product. Now let's see the overview of the project. So the basic overview of the project is, like, the first thing is admin will add the products into the application, and thereby customer can view the products on home page. And now customer can add the products into the cart. Then after that, for ordering those products which are in the cart, he have to enter the cart details. So after successfully entering the cart details, now customer can order the product successfully. And now after this, admin and customer will be able to see the order details. By the way, admin will be able to see all the order details by any customer, and particular customer will be able to see his order only. So now admin can assign the delivery person for this order. After assigning the delivery person, and now delivery person will be able to see his delivery orders which he have to deliver for the customer. And after assigning the delivery person, customer can also view the delivery person's detail. And now, since this order is assigned to delivery person will be able to update the delivery status, like processing, on the way, and he can also update the delivery time for the order. And at the last, all these details will be visible to customer, delivery person, and the admin. So this was a basic overview of the project, and now let's see the complete project. But before that, I would like to request you guys to please like, share, and subscribe my YouTube channel for more such project videos. I hope this project will help a lot of students for learning React.js and Spring Boot MySQL project. By referring to this, they can develop their own project, and thereby they can grow their skills.
So now, without wasting any time, let's get into the screen. So this is HTS4. I have used HTS4 for developing our REST APIs. Okay, this is our project online shopping. Okay, this is the complete structure of the project. As I had already mentioned, I have used Maven for our project and dependency management. This is our pom.xml file. Here I have added all the required dependencies. Okay, this is src main java package, resources, application.properties. Here I have declared all the packages, controller, DAO, DTO, model, service, utility. Now let's run the project. So for running the project, I will right click on the project, run as Spring Boot app. Okay, our Spring Boot application is getting start. Okay, so our Spring Boot application got started on port 8080. Okay. And now let's see the front end code also. So basically this is our React.js project. This is complete structure of the project. Okay, all the components I have declared here. Okay, so let's run this project also. npm start. It is getting start. So till then, let's see the logs of till now we are not receiving any request from the front end because it is not started yet. Let it start first. So our front end is getting load now. Okay, so this is our front end. And now if we see our Spring Boot application logs, we can see here we started to receive the request from the front end. Okay. And we can see here all the categories and products are visible here. Okay, since this data are present in our DB. So after hitting the APIs, we are getting the response from the application and we are displaying that data on our front end. So basically this is our home page, which I have made using the React.js. So at first, when user will visit on our website, he will be able to see all the categories present in our website. And also he will be able to see all the products which are present on our website. And one more thing, we are able to see all these things, categories, products, detail, because I had already logged in as admin and had added all these details in our project. So let's check our database also. So I'm using command prompt for opening our MySQL server. We can use MySQL workbench also for opening MySQL server. Okay, I'll use the command localhost user root, hit enter. I have not kept any password. Okay, I will select the DB name, online shopping. Okay, let's see all the tables present in our application. So tables, so totally 6 tables we are using. Okay, address, card, category, orders, product, and user. All the user details will be stored in the user table. So in the front end, we can see at first when user will visit on our website, he will be able to see all the categories and the products. Okay, and in the navigation bar, he will be able to see about us, contact us page, which are static. Along with that, on the right side of the navigation bar, we can see register user and login user. And this is role based. So user can register himself by selecting the role. So firstly, what we will do is, firstly, we will register admin, customer, and delivery person. Firstly, I will register admin. Okay, I will write admin Murad. Code, we can keep anything. For demo purpose, we can enter anything. Admin Murad. Password, I will keep 123456. Mobile number, I can enter anything. Then I will register user. Registered successfully. And now again, if I check my DB, we can see the data got added here. Okay, adminmurad@gmail.com. In the similar way, let's also register customer and delivery person. Customer Murad. Okay, code with Murad, we can enter anything. Okay, I will write here customer Murad. Okay, enter the password as 123456. Can enter anything here. Register user, we can check DB. Customer data got also added here. You can see the role here, admin, customer. Now let's add the delivery person also. I will select the delivery person role. Then I will write here delivery person Murad. You can write Ali here. Then I will give the email as delivery Murad. Enter the password 123456. You can enter any data here. Okay, register user. Okay, let's check the DB. We can see all three user got added here, admin, customer, and the delivery person. So firstly, let's log in as a admin and add category and product. So I will log in as an admin. I will select the role as admin, and here I can enter the admin's email ID. Okay. So I will select the admin's email ID. Copy. This is the admin. Okay. I'll paste here. Password 123456. Then I will click on login. So once admin will log in into the system, he will be able to see some more options in the navigation bar. We can see here add category, add product, all orders, assign order delivery, and logout option. Okay, so firstly let's add the category here. I will add the category as bed. Okay, this category contain all the bed products. You can write anything here. Okay, and here we can see bed category got added here. But if we click here in the bed, since till now we haven't added any bed product here, that's why it is empty here. Okay, like if I click on shoes, then we can see two shoes are present in the application. If you click on the mobile, all the mobile products will display on the website. Laptop, watch, book. Okay, so based on the category also user can search the products. Okay, and also here also we can see women gown. Okay, if I click here, this is the category only. If I click here, then all the gowns will be displayed. Okay, all categories. Let's see one more example. If I click here mobile category, then all the mobile will display here. So from here also we can search the products by categories. Okay, now let's add our bed product. So firstly I have to enter the title, then description, select category as bed, and quantity I will add as 100. I'll keep the price as 15,000. I will choose the picture, bed image. So now if I click on bed, we can see here the bed product got added here. Okay, we can see the bed product here on the home page. If I click on all categories at below, we can see our product got added here. Okay, also we can search by using the category. After this, admin will be able to see all the orders by the customer. So whichever product customer will order, firstly admin will be able to see all the orders by the customers. And after that, admin can also assign the delivery person for the order. So firstly, let's see how customer can order the products. Okay, so for that, firstly I will log out as an admin and log in as a customer to order some products. So I will log in as a customer. This is the latest user, customer, which we had added. Enter email ID, password. So once customer will log in into the system, he will be able to see two more options like my cart and my order. If we see my cart, this is empty because till now customer has not added any product into the cart. And also if we check my orders, this will be also empty because till now we haven't ordered any product. Okay, so let's add some products into the cart first. Okay, so let's suppose he wants to order this iPhone. We can enter the quantity here. And one more thing, when customer will open any product, so all the related products will be visible below that products, like we can see here. Okay, so let's add one quantity here. I will add to cart. Okay, so product got added successfully. Now from here let's also add this bed, okay, which we have just added in the application. Okay, so I will order this also in one quantity. Okay, got added. Then after that, let's also order one shoes. I will add here two shoes. Okay, and one headphone also is there, so I will add this also in the cart. Okay, got added. Now if I go to the my cart, we are able to see all the products in the cart which we had added in the cart. Okay, so let's suppose if customer wants to delete some product from the cart which he don't want to order, so you will get option of delete, okay, to remove the product from the cart. Okay, let's suppose he don't want this headphone, okay, so simply he can remove this by clicking on delete button. I will click delete and we can see that product got removed from the cart. Okay, now after adding all the products into the cart, customer can order the products. So for that, customer will be able to see the total amount for all the products which he had added in the cart. Okay, so the total amount is visible here. Okay, and below that he will get the checkout button, okay, to enter the cart details. Okay, so I'll click on the checkout. Okay, so he will be able to see the total amount which he have to pay, and this is the dummy payment details. Okay, we can enter any detail here, okay, because this is just a dummy page I have added. So I will click on pay button to order the product, and we can see our products ordered successfully. Okay, and one more thing, after ordering the product, customer's cart will get empty. Okay, so if same user click on my cart, all the products will be get deleted from here. Okay, because he has ordered all the products and the amount is zero here. Okay, and if he check my orders, all the products got ordered here and he has got the order ID. Okay, all the order ID are same because he has ordered all the products in one time. Okay, but the delivery date, the delivery status, the delivery person details is pending because admin will assign delivery person for this order. So let's check our DB also. I will check the orders table to see whether this order got added in our table or not. Select star from orders. So we can see our three product got added here. Okay, we can see order ID here. KUDNU, something like that. KUDNU. Okay, so our products got added in the orders table and the status is pending. Pending. Okay. And now let's log out as a customer and log in again as an admin to assign a delivery person for this order because the delivery status and the delivery detail is still pending. Okay, so I will log out as a customer and I will log in as an admin. I will select the role admin, admin Murad. So now if admin checks all order, then he will be able to see the latest orders by the customer. Okay, so we can see here customer Murad has ordered 3 products. Okay, and admin can see the order ID for those orders. Okay, and he can also see the delivery status is pending. Okay, so what admin can do is he can select the order ID, okay, and assign the delivery person to this order. So firstly he will enter the order ID here to check the complete status. So we can see here after searching the order by order ID, admin is able to see all the complete detail and the delivery status is pending only. So now admin can assign the delivery person for this order. Okay, so I will select this order ID and paste this order ID here because we have to update this delivery status. And we can see here all the delivery persons are visible here which are present in our website. Total 4 delivery persons are available as of now. So that's why all the delivery persons are visible here. And if you notice, this is the delivery person which we had just added few minutes ago. Okay, so I will select this delivery person only and after that I will click on assign delivery person. So as soon as I click on this button, assign delivery person, immediately we can see the effect here. Like delivery person name is delivery person Murad and his contact detail is visible here and the same detail will be visible to the customer also. Now he can see the delivery person detail. If he has any query, he can contact this delivery person using his contact number. So now let's log out as an admin and log in as this delivery person Murad, okay, to update the delivery status. Okay, because delivery person has right to update the delivery status. So I will log out as an admin and log in as a delivery person to update the delivery status for that order. Okay, so I will click on login. Okay, so as soon as delivery person logins into the application, he will get two more options in the navigation bar, that is my deliveries. In this option, he will be able to see all the orders which is assigned to him by the admin. So for this order, he has been assigned by the admin, but he can also see the delivery date and delivery status is pending only. Okay, so what he can do is, now he can again copy the order ID and he will click on update order delivery. So from here he can search that particular orders. Okay, so total 3 products are there in this order. Okay, delivery date and status is pending only. So now he can update the delivery date and status. Before that, let's also check our DB. Okay, so I will select star from order. So I will check the orders. So we can see here delivery date is pending only, but delivery person ID got updated here. And at below he can see update delivery status option, from where he can update the delivery status for this order. So he will copy the order ID, enter the order ID here, select the delivery date. So from here he can select the delivery date. After that, he will be able to see the delivery time, like approximate time, like at the evening customer will receive his order. Then he can also select the delivery status, like whether it is delivered, whether it is on the way, or it is in processing. So as of now, let's select on the way and update the delivery status. So as soon as I click on the update delivery status, we can see the delivery date and the delivery status got updated here. Okay, we can see the changes here. And now let's also check our orders. Same query I will hit here, and we can see the delivery date and delivery status got updated here. Okay, and the same details will be visible to admin, customer and delivery person. And now let's log out as a delivery person and log in as a customer to see whether the delivery status got updated or not. So I will log in as a customer. To check the status, so I'll click on my order, and now customer can see the delivery status got updated. Delivery date he can see here, and the timing, like at evening he will receive his product. Delivery status also he can see on the way, and the delivery person detail also he can see here. So this was the complete project. I hope you guys liked each and every functionality which I have added in this project. If you guys feel like some more functionality should also be present in the project, then please do comment in the comment section. I'll definitely going to add those functionalities also in the future. And I hope this project will help lot of students for developing their project, like which functionality they can also add in their project. And lastly, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, please like, share and subscribe to my YouTube channel. And we'll meet soon in my next video. Till then, take care and bye-bye.